To continue our discussion on the importance of the center of rotation in orthodontic tooth movement, I'll present this short video to highlight the best way to move this tooth from this position to this position using some simple calculations to allow us to get the correct moment to force ratio in this condition. So the first thing we need to find out is where is the tooth moving to. So the center resistance one, which is the initial movement, goes to center of resistance number two, which is now a bit higher and distal to the first one. We make a perpendicular to the first center resistance at a distance of 13 millimeters, considering that this incisor is 25 millimeters. In orange, we have the line of action of the force. And this is now the force that is needed to take the center resistance from this position to this position, but it does not take into account the rotation of the incisor, which needs a moment that we will calculate in relation to the center rotation. For this purpose, we use a graph that has been published in Biomechanics in Orthodontics ebook from Dr. Fiorelli and Melson, my mentors, which I strongly suggest to buy if you want to understand biomechanics. It can be found at http://biomechanics.com. And because I speak English, I use the English version. So how is the moment calculated that is necessary to rotate this tooth? Again, we're going to be looking at the graph. If D equals 13 millimeters and the root length is roughly 15 or 18, if we take 18, we'll have about 7. So if D equals 13 millimeters and the root is between 15 and 18 millimeters long, considering that the tooth is 25 millimeters, then the moment to force ratio will be at CR, will be 7. So what we have now, we know that the M divided by F equals 7 to get this kind of a movement. If D2 equals the moment to force ratio equals 7, or the moment equals F times D2, so D2 now equals 7 millimeters. And if I take the force on this line of action, which is purple, I take this force right here and I bring it right down here, I have the same simple force that is acting on the center resistance, and I create a moment F times D2, which is equal to 7. So this force right here is equivalent to this force system right here. And you may want to ask, what can I do to get this force? Well, a simple system is to put a bracket and an extension where you will tie a cantilever with this inclination and you'll get the correct moment to force ratio. Or you can definitely use a different system where you'll take the moment to the bracket and add a force. This force here can be also applied at this point of application. So the same force. So F here is the same and a moment will be the same as F here with this moment. So the two systems are the same and you will get a moment to force ratio of 7, or again you can put the force right here and get the same effect. The center is a rotation which is located accurately here will allow you to determine the moment to force ratio, and looking at the displacement of the center resistance will give you the line of action of the force. Hopefully this was clear enough. If you have any problems, don't hesitate to comment and I will try to explain better. Thank you very much.